who certainly want to be targeted throughout the game. It's Hopkins' Texans going up against Green's Bengals. With that, let's welcome in our fine broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, we are in the place the folks here call the jungle, and that's Paul Brownsium in Cincinnati. This crowd loves their orange and black. The scene just a short time ago, they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for football as the Bengals get set to do battle with the Houston Texans. Hello, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. As we get set here, Charles, we talk about wide receivers. You know, Larry mentioned it in the open, but that's a big spot to look at here in this one.
I think he identified it perfectly because these guys have such an impact on the game nowadays because they throw the ball more than ever. And whether they're throwing it short, medium, or long, can they snatch it out of the air and create even extra yardage with run after catch?
This is taken at the 3. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. So out come the Texans for their opening drive. The former national champion at Clemson bringing him onto the field, and that's the signal caller, Deshaun Watson.
Played for a national championship his last 2 years at Clemson. He was drafted for a specific purpose by the Houston Texans, to get them deeper into the playoffs and possibly to a Super Bowl. That's why they moved up to number 12 in the draft to select this guy out of Clemson.
This is Lamar Miller. Space to maneuver at the 40. Lamar Miller, the 30. Touchdown, Houston. Lamar Miller, 75 yards. And the Texans have taken the early lead. The first play from scrimmage. Some of these people haven't even taken their seat.
That's what is commonly known as a fast start. That's what my horse racing friends would say. They called a flyer out of the gate, and guess what? They're in the lead now.
A try here for the extra point. And the Texans take a 7-0 lead. One of the shortest drives you'll ever see. One play, 75 yards, 6 points. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Here come the Bengals now to take over. They'll be led out by the Red Rifle. From TCU, it's Andy Dalton.
And remember, he was a day one starter his rookie year, and that was the year of the lockout, so he didn't even get the OTAs and minicamp that led into it, led his team to the playoffs that year, led his team to the playoffs his first 5 years in the league before a 6-9-1 record in 2016.
Play fake here on first down. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Brian Cushing coming hard on the blitz. He dumps him for a loss of 8.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast, and a big sack.
Hey.
They'll run for the first time with Hill. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
All right, partner, let's go back over the last couple of plays. Sack, loss of yards on a running play. Not exactly the sequence that an offensive coordinator gets comfortable with when calling plays.
And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long. From the gun, Dalton looks to throw. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line, J.J. Watt coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it'll be fourth down.
There's a little bit of defense right there. Nickel set, 5 defensive backs. They just snuffed out every route that was going. Quarterback never got rid of the football.
Here's Kevin Huber now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. Fair catch taken just inside the 40-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt, and the Texans take possession. Heading out is the Texans offense as they get set to take over here. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in, because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. They'll start out on the ground. It's Lamar Miller. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8. And let's look here at the Houston offense.
When you think of the Texans, you think this is a team that likes to throw the football. In 2016, though, they weren't very good at it. 29th overall in passing, but they were 8th in rushing. So let's see if they lean on the running game to start this contest. And they're hoping to get more consistency throwing the ball downfield.
2nd down following the run. They'll fake the handoff. Now Watson. Right side caught, Fedorowicz. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. Just the first quarter, but tackling going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you, from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season open opponent, and they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best of them. I tackled him on the first pass of the game, and the relief was incredible. I ended up having a pretty decent ball game. But if I had missed him, it would have been a
different story
all night.
A first down carry now for Miller. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
4 yards remaining now on 2nd down. Watson hands to Miller on the draw, and he'll go down at the 28. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going, and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
Everyone come forward, go down. Let's go.
play action here on first down. He's going to go up top for the end zone. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect. The defensive starters now for Cincinnati.
The Cincinnati defense is well respected around the league, but they didn't play to their standard in 2016. If you just look at the pure numbers, ended up 17th overall in total defense. But in the tough division that they're in, the AFC North, they have to be better against the run. They ranked just 21st in 2016. That's got to change for them to make the improvement they want in 2017.
So second and 10 here. Now a play fake, and it's Watson. This will be caught inside the 10. A good pickup there, a 22.
Normally, when I talk about DeAndre Hopkins, I'm talking about accomplishments. In this case, I'm remembering that he lost nearly 600 yards in receiving from 2015. He had less than 1,000 last year.
Yeah, and his touchdowns dropped from 11 to 4, so now he's hoping for more consistent quarterback play. So they're operating in the red zone. Now a run. This is Alfred Blue. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack. And on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against?
Neutral zone infraction.
So 5 yards there is one of the big guys up front moved.
And in a 4-3 front, you got the two defensive tackles right near the football. I know there's a lot of movement around there, but they're always taught to have one eye on the football. Apparently, that didn't happen.
They come out here in the eye. Offense working with a second and goal now from the 3. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2.
He's already scored once. He definitely had his eyes wide open trying to get in there a second time, but I thought that was a really nice play defensively to deny him.
Yeah, it was. As you said, keeping him away from his second first quarter touchdown there. This defense hasn't let him in yet. They'll need to stiffen here. Third and goal from the 2.
Let's go!
They'll try to punch it in with Miller. And not even back to the line of scrimmage this time as they're on him quickly once more. And a loss of 3 to bring up 4. Looking at this situation, if you're at the 1, the 2, maybe you go for it. From here, you kick him.
I agree. I think you have to get points in this situation. Fourth down, I don't chance it at all. I put the points on the board and go back and regroup.
Now the Texans are going to call on the field goal unit. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And his kick is good. And the lead moves to 10-0. So give them 3 there. A good drive gets them inside the 5, but they couldn't punch it in.
And credit this defense, too. That was the old bend but don't break approach. But it kept the offense out of the end zone.
utilize the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. On the return, it's Alex Erickson. And down he goes just shy of the 25. Now, penalty marker is down. Let's see what that's about.
Illegal block in the back. Return team.
Yeah, this is going to put him back with a not great field position.
So they really got zero benefit at all, right? Sometimes you can absorb a penalty when you get a big return, then the penalty brings it back, but you still have great field position. As you pointed out, not in this case.
To Hill, and he's going to be taken down right at about the 15-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. Here now the offense for the Bengals.
When you're right on the verge of being a top 10 overall offense in the NFL, you would think that things are pretty good for your team, but the Bengals want to improve. They were 13th in rushing, and for a team that wants to run the football first, last, and always, that's an area that they're trying to jump up in 2017.
9 yards still remaining here to pick up the first on second down. It's second down. Dalton looking. This is going to be caught by the rookie. It's John Ross. And they'll get him down here at the 23. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't
they?
Yeah,
when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
They'll try and run for it. Here's Hill. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down.
I know it's the first half, but it's still hard to curb the enthusiasm for that stop. Third and one, and the offense can't get there. The defensive team has got to feel very good about themselves. Great job out-leveraging the offense.
Here's Kevin Huber now. On for his second punt, he'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. 47 yards on the punt that time, just 1 yard on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Texans offense now, they get set to head back on the field here. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Off of play action, it's Watson. He's letting this one go for Fuller. And that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown, Houston. Will Fuller, 72 yards. And the Texans will add on to their lead. It took them a while to get their speedster involved, but they found him downfield there.
And what we've discovered as we've watched games is the speedster doesn't have to have a lot of catches, doesn't have to have volume in order to have a huge impact on the game. His speed scares the heck out of defenses, and other guys can capitalize, but when you finally hit him and he carries it all the way into the end zone, that's what you're paying him for. That big threat that can make big plays on a limited number of catches.
That's how you step on the stage with your first catch. Take it to the house. Now the extra point. He's got it, and it's 17-0. And we can break that scoring drive down pretty easily. One play, long touchdown pass into the end zone. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This fielded at the 2. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Now this Bengals offensive unit ready to see what they can do here.
This is their third drive. Right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
Now Dalton with a 1st and 10. And shoving his way inside the 35. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. First down carry, it's Hill. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. They'll get 14 on that one. Good for a Bengal first down.
I have to admit, I'm excited by that play call and the end result, because this is a team that's down big early in the first quarter, and a lot of teams will just panic, abandon the playbook, and just start firing the ball all over the place. It's way too early for that. Stick to what works for you.
Down double digits, and we talked about their game plan being both running and passing there. You're right. They're sticking to the game plan, getting the ground game going.
A lot of football left to be played.
From midfield here, Dalton. Underneath here to Hill. And he's brought down. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
Nice little nifty play for him there. You know, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody cut. Oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down.
Down Hill, and he'll get 4 here down to the 35-yard line. The defensive crew for the Texans, here's a look.
The Houston Texans in 2016 on defense defied convention. Why? J.J. Watt missed most of the season, so you would expect them to struggle a little bit, but in fact, this was the #1 overall defense in the NFL. They stopped the run, forced teams to throw the football, and really got after him with a terrific pass rush.
2nd down of the offense in search of 6 yards. Now a 1st carry for Giovanni Bernard. And he'll go down at the 28. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. Well, you're down early. How do you get back in the game? Maybe establish the run. I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one. And what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offense coordinator, let's run the football. Let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
And before they can get settled in here, time expires. On the first quarter of action, already 17-0 our score. We'll return to Cincinnati after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, and it's the Bengals with a football to begin quarter number two. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. With a give to Hill, and he'll get this one down to about the 27. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. They run it again with Hill. And they've got it in the red zone now, down at about the 19. Calling an 8 yard gain, much better shape now on third and just a yard.
Kid had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Bootlegs out, and Eifert has it, and he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football, but not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Took them a lot of plays, but hey, they did the job.
And the defense always preaches getting off the field, making a play, and turning it back over to their own offense. Unable to do so. A long, sustained drive by the offense.
On for the point after is Randy Bullock. And it's 17-7. That time, a 9-play drive, and it's finished off with a Cincinnati touchdown. Out now to kick this one away. This fielded at the 2. Then he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Now the Texans offense, they head back out to do battle here. And last time the formula was pretty simple. 1-play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, 1-play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here. They begin with a run by Miller. And he'll get about 3 here as he's out to the 30.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Throw on second is Watson. And he's got it over the middle. Fedorowicz. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
Watson going to give this one to Miller. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
Second down, here's Miller. And he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a 3rd and about 4.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
And on 3rd down, a nickel formation here defensively. A shotgun snap for Watson, and this is going to be incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this 3rd down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
Here now, Shane Leckler, 41-year-old punter, to kick it away. Back deep for the Bengals, Adam Jones. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. So now the Bengal offensive unit back out onto the field. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
They start the drive on the ground with Hill. And a great move on the play as he takes this one past the 25. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Again, it's Hill, and not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a 3rd down and 2.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense, and guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time, but you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Hill, and a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back at the 29. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a 4th down.
Well, they picked up a portion of it, but not all that they needed. Now that leads to a decision on 4th and 1. Let's see what they decide to do.
Here's Here's Kevin Huber now, as he's on to punt for Cincinnati. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Oh, nice move. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Now Deshaun Watson and his offense heading back out there. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number two here in the second quarter. Watson, off play action. Going deep for Hopkins. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
But one thing's for sure, when you've got a big receiver and you trust him downfield, you got to give him opportunities to go up and get that 50-50 ball.
And he is a darn good big receiver. Unfortunately, that time didn't work out. Nice job defensively. And still needing 10 yards. Second down.
Here we go. Red 38. Cut.
Throwing again is Watson. On the right side, this is Miller. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And a nickel look here for the Bengals as they try to defend this on third.
Here we go. Red 38.
Here's Watson. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 5 yards on the screen, but that'll take us to fourth down.
They dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second, it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
Here's Shane Leckler now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Putting the books as a 53-yard punt, and the Bengals take possession. Jeremy Hill now gearing up to go again as he marches back onto the field. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call in the West Coast offense, the long handoff?
Yeah.
Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
I think if they want to start getting back into this game, it behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive. Dalton throwing on second down. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete. He was looking for John Ross that time, and it'll bring up third down.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Third down, a shot here for Dalton. Underneath, this is Bernard. Bernard churning, and he lost.
toss the football, and the Texans scoop it. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But, hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big-time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
Deshaun Watson and the Texans offense trot back out there. He's got to be feeling pretty good. Playing well. Team has the lead, so just looking to mount a drive here that ends in the end zone.
And all quarterbacks will tell you, hey, we love a running game, helps us out. But at the end of the day, they want to rely on their arm, throw the football, feel good about things, keep things moving in the right direction. Right now, that's exactly what we're seeing.
And we'll see if that continues. And a great spot to start this drive from here. Tip carry now for Lamar Miller. And some room to roam now. And now look at this. Big game, but a fumble. And the Bengals grab it. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
Here's A.J. Green as he gets set to go again on offense. You better believe that he's well aware he has zero catches right now, and they're losing, so he's probably a little hungry.
And you know the guys on defense are aware as well, and they're really excited that he has no catches, but they're also worried because a lot of times, that's like the ticking time bomb. The longer you hold him down, when he finally explodes, look out.
Yeah, no catches, though, so far in this game. Very tough spot here for the offense to start. They begin the drive with Hill. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
First carry for their fullback. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Dalton gives to Bernard. And a short gain here as he gets it up only to about the six. A minute 59 to go in the first half. We'll come back to Cincinnati after this. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Larry Ridley is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. Here's Kevin Huber now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And out will come the offense as they take over. And a look now at Lamar Miller. We're in the second quarter. They've got the lead. The lead, though, not so much because of the ground game, because of their air attack, Charles.
So what they're seeing so far is the possibility of things loosening up later in the ground game. Through the air first, maybe they have to start respecting that even more as the game goes on, and then there will be running lanes to find later.
Yeah, try to get him more involved here on this drive, maybe. On first down, Watson throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Thank you. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Watson throwing again. He's letting this one go for Fuller. That's caught inside the 20. They give him a gain of 37.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
And on the left side, Fedorowicz has it. And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. C.J. Fedorowicz, an 18-yard touchdown grab. And the Texans will extend their lead. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Extra point attempt here still to come. And that'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves to 17. The drive there only spanning three plays, and it results in the Texans finding the end zone. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be fielded at the 8. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
First and 10 for Dalton. Under pressure, and the Texans able to get in there for the sack. And before the second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout, as he'll stop it with exactly a minute to go before halftime. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. Second down, Dalton, and he's able to get up here to the 26. And a stoppage here, a timeout before this third down play takes place. As the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. So the offensive unit called the TO, And now we are ready to resume play. And the Bengals on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is third and 9. Out of the gun, it's Dalton. And able to find Green. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A big third down conversion with a gain of 28. From the gun, Dalton looks to throw. And a right side completion here by LaFell. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. First down throw coming for Dalton. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jonathan Joseph. So we have reached halftime here. It's the visitors, the Texans, out in front. As we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Bengals haven't played their best football and trail because of it. The Texans have looked good on the road and will just try to keep the ball rolling in the second half. All right, let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. First and 10, Miller is able to get clear of everybody, and he'll go in for the score as they take a 7-0 lead. Now first and 10, Fuller is wide open down the field. He gone. The lead now at 17. We go now to early in the second. Dalton hooks up with his speedy rookie from Washington, John Ross. And he cap off the long drive with a TD, cutting the deficit to 10. Texans take over late in the second. Here a throw deep down the field is caught, staying late in the second. And he won't be brought down until he makes it to the 18-yard line. Pass coverage will break down here. And after the short pass, he'll score. Staying late in the half. Texans push the lead to 17. Dalton's got the completion here, and he'll end up at the 45-yard line before being tackled. So that's it for us at the EA Sports Studio. We'll go back now to Cincinnati for the start of the second half.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Here we go with a player spotlight, and we shine that spotlight on Andy Dalton. And maybe he's starting to wave the white flag a little bit. He's playing pretty well, but the pressure, it's got to him.
Has to find a way to step around it, step through it, or just handle it. Because as you mentioned, he's having a pretty good day overall. Just the hits keep coming and taking those sacks. That's not the way that they want to finish a ball game with their quarterback on the ground so much.
Now he'd like to stay upright. When he's been upright, he's been pretty good. Start the second half with Hill. And he's not even going to get back to the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
If these guys are going to chop into that deficit, they got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage would be found.
Second down, Hill. And he's going to get about 7 yards on that one, up to around the 33.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
Passing, it's Dalton. Complete to the right side, it's Eifert. And he finally goes down at the 23-yard line. A big play there on the catch and run. 44 yards.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. To throw here, Dalton. It's a loss of 5 there, bringing up second. It's second down, Dalton looking, and over the middle, it's LaFell, and he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. The Bengals passing game finding a rhythm. They've got another first.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision, and receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
From the gun, Dalton, and it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
You get a tight end like this and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here he's the one that has to absorb the contact and as a result unable to hold on to the football.
So second and goal here from the 9. Dalton to Hill on the draw. And this time he's going backwards. So after the no gain on the last attempt, here they get him behind the line. He already has 2 sacks to his credit. Now another tackle for loss.
And you know how you can always identify who was supposed to block him? They're the ones helping up the person who just got knocked to the ground with the ball, right? Whether it's a running play or a pass play, they've got to figure out a way to slow him down. Maybe you chip him with a second guy. Maybe you just out and out double him. Maybe you make sure you take the ball and throw it as far away from him as possible. Because right now, he is wrecking things for them.
Throwing, Dalton. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on third down.
Pass interference.
And since the penalty occurred in the end zone, move the ball to the 1 yard line.
First and goal from the 1 yard line. Costly penalty.
Go, go. And Dalton to throw. Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7. Brandon Dunn in there to get him for a loss of 5.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Yards still to go here on 2nd and goal. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. Jeremy Hill, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Bengals are able to draw a bit closer. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there's an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
So that drive consumes 9 plays all told, and it ends with a Jeremy Hill touchdown run. Out now to kick this one away. This is taken at the 3. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Here's the Texans offense now, readying for their first possession of the second half. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Into a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down. And 3rd quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you've stopped the clock and you've helped out the guys on the other side of the ball. So keep it in the hands of those runners. Keep moving it, keep grinding the clock.
They'll run it again with Miller. And he'll get 2, maybe 3, up near the 37.
3rd quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
The Texans on 3rd down, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is 3rd and 4. Gun, Watson, and that is incomplete.
Pardon me, the way this offense has marched up and down the field during this game, it's almost a surprise to see an incomplete pass on 3rd down, isn't it?
Yeah, they have had their foot on the gas all game long, but here finally stalling out. Here's Shane Leckler now as he's on to punt for Houston. Jones on the return. A good return there. Call it 13 yards. The Bengals getting set to go. They come in off a touchdown drive the last time they had the ball that cut down that lead. Now the defense has done their part, got them the football back.
Momentum started to shift a little bit when they scored the touchdown. It increased when the defense got them the ball back. Momentum definitely in their favor. Now they got to keep things cranking, keep it on high so they can keep cutting into that lead.
Play fake here on first down. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. He was looking for his favorite target, A.J. Green, that time. And that'll bring up second down. They have not gotten him going at all. Tried to spark something there with a longer throw, unable to complete it.
But you have to keep trying. He's one of their best playmakers. No matter what it says on the scoreboard, you're always trying to get him the football.
The busy night continues for Hill, and he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. Give him four on the ground there. They're now left with third and six.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Third down, Dalton, and Eifert has it, and he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Dalton to his big target, Eifert, for the Cincinnati first.
And there's another completion to the tight end, and let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
They go play action here on first down. Try to lay one up deep. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down.
I know I'm not giving enough credit to the defenders because that pass was incomplete. But come on, it was A.J. Green. I always expect him to come up with the ball.
Yeah, on those deep routes especially, even on incompletions, it's fun to watch him run those routes.
It certainly is, but he eats up ground, and he usually goes up and gets it.
Second down now after the incompletion. They'll run it with Hill. Get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 12 yards that time and a Cincinnati first down.
That, quite simply, is Jeremy Hill, a very powerful compact back.
He's always been that. Even back at LSU, that's where he honed that skill, right?
Love to run between the tackles and take the contact as well as dish it out.
So it'll be first down here after the run. Right
left, right left. Four, four down.
The play fake to Hill, Dalton. Oh, he's got a little daylight and avoids the contact by sliding. Call it a gain of five, and that'll make this a second down. So second and medium, second and five now. On the carry, it's Hill. Some extra space following the display of power. Down just inside the 45. After a gain of five, they'll wind up being about a length of the football short here on third down.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
third down. That's Hill. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well.
I like the look that they just showed there. When you come out in a passing formation, spread things out a little bit, makes it really hard to cover the middle field, doesn't it? Because you got to go out to the perimeter and cover those guys.
Yep, exactly. Got some good blocking, too. Helped him pick up the first. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. Here's Bernard, and he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there, second down.
While there is no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window, and they've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
Now whistles and a flag, and I believe a Bengal got going a little early there.
False start, offense.
And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. Again, here's Bernard, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards will get him back to the original line of scrimmage, but now they're looking at third and 10.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Now the Bengals on third down. They've hit on half of them, 5 for 10. This is third and 10. Dalton here from the gun. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. Whitney Merciless in there to get him for a loss of three, and it'll be fourth down.
My man, it's been a rough night for that offensive line, and it's only getting rougher. 5 sacks now that they've given up in this contest so far. It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the witching hour. That's when everything goes haywire late at night.
So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for three, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. This will be from 56 yards out. Crossbar, no good. A long-range effort denied 3 points at the very end. All things considered, a pretty good kick. Just cruel punishment there to be denied by the crossbar.
If you're going to hit from that distance, sometimes you're going to need a little luck. And unfortunately for him, this time the break goes against him.
And let's shift our attention to Will Fuller. Good day for him so far here in the third quarter. He's hit pay dirt once, over 100 yards, but hey, it's the third quarter. He's thinking, I want more, right?
He wants more, and it just increases the confidence of his team because every play he makes, that means his quarterback is really feeling good about throwing the football. Probably feels like he can't throw an incomplete pass when he throws it to him right now.
Yeah, he's looked really, really sharp. They'll start out on the ground. It's Lamar Miller. And he works his way forward for about four up to the midfield stripe.
An opportunity to get a drive started here at the end of the third quarter. What you're trying to do is break the game down a little bit. Don't let your guys see too deep into the game, into the future, and say, oh, we got to get here. No, right here, right in front of them, melt the clock down, get to the fourth quarter, try and keep going.
And try to keep that lead.
Exactly.
Back now in Cincinnati. It's the Texans in control of the football and leading this game as well as we start the fourth. Again, it's Miller. And some space here. Quick move by Miller. Breaks the tackle. Now an alley. He's still fighting forward. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. A big play on the ground there and goes for 36 yards.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
Fresh set of downs here. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Got a man open. It's Fuller for the Texans touchdown. Will Fuller, his second touchdown of the night. And the Texans capitalize on the fumble and turn it into six.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Extra point attempt to come here. And that'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves to 17. One play, two plays, touchdown. That's all it took there. A very short and sweet drive that got him in the end zone. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Bengals offense now, they head back onto the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Movement there on the offensive line, a little quick, and a 5-yard penalty.
Offense.
So that'll back him up 5. Gun. Dalton. He finds Ross. Right side. It's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Decent start to the drive, but let's face it, they need a lot of things to go right in a short amount of time, down 3 scores.
Yeah, they're going to run their 2-minute offense here in this game, but this is for future games. Can they get better and be ready for the next time? Hopefully with a chance to win.
Second down, Hill. Call it a gain of 4, and it'll leave him with a 3rd down and 6 to go.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
And the Bengals on third down. They've converted five times in their many chances thus far. This will be third and six. Operating from the gun, Dalton. He's got his man here. It's Green. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field.
Holding offense.
Well, there have been a ton of sacks. They were just trying to prevent another.
So what you're telling me is the conventional way has not really worked for them, huh?
Not at all.
Not at all. So he tries to grab him here, and they still get caught.
And the Bengals on third down. They've converted five times in their many chances thus far. This is third and 16. So Dalton now. And that's complete to LaFell. And he'll be down deep in Houston territory. A big play there on the catch and run. 62 yards. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
And now a first down following that long gain. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw it through three quarters. No reason to lighten up now. Throwing on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That's very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. They look to throw on third with Dalton. The quick slant caught. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the 2. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defensive side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. And here we go on first and goal. Now Hill. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
Now whistles and a flag, and I believe a Bengal got going a little early there.
False start, offense.
And that'll set them back 5. Second and goal. They still need 8 yards to find the end zone. And he bowls his way into the end zone for a Bengal touchdown.
Jeremy Hill with his second touchdown of the night. And the Bengals are able to cut into this lead. Now he's doing his part, but still facing a sizable deficit.
And he would like to do more, but he needs help from the other two-thirds, right? He needs his defense to bow up a little bit, and he also needs special teams to maybe create some big plays and help them get back in it.
Now Bullock to add the extra point. And the lead is trimmed down to 10. So that drive goes 8 plays, and it ends with a Jeremy Hill touchdown run. Out now to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. And here comes the Texans now. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
First down carry now for Miller. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
But Brandon, pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, this is by Thema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech.
Come on, let's go! One, nine.
To throw on second is Watson. And he'll be taken down by the Bengal pressure. Michael Johnson in there to bury him for a loss of 11.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
Gonna need something special here on third and long. After that sack, what does Watson have in his arsenal? Watson, off play action. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Fuller. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Big hookup there, forced to throw it on third down. The connection's going to keep the drive alive and also keep the clock moving.
Yeah, and from a defensive perspective, didn't get a sack, didn't knock the ball free, didn't break up the pass. The clock keeps running on you. You're in a dire situation now.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Now Miller, he's had a big workload here tonight. Quick move by Miller. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
And that's a good run, and I know he went out of bounds, so we could nitpick a little bit here and get on him and say, hey, make sure you stay in bounds, keep the clock running. But this stage of the game, Brandon, that's not really uppermost in his mind. He just wants to take care of the football and gain yardage.
Yeah, and they have a little bit of comfort there with it not just being a one-score game, so not too nitpicky. So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set.
Come on, let's go.
Miller. And he'll work his way inside the 30 now to the 28. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Let's go! Brad, 38!
They'll run with Miller. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He lost two there, and it's third down. Finally, defensively, they have a little clip to show positive for actually stopping him running the football.
It's been a really long night for them, hasn't it? So they got a little bit of a win there, but let's face it, the vision that he's had running the football has carried his feet to the open spaces and the big yardage all night long.
The Texans on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This will be third and five. Back to throw, Watson. Found his target, it's Anderson. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
This is Miller. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And again, he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. Back-to-back stops make it third and 10. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Let's go! One, nine.
They'll try and run again with Blue. Down right around the 25. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. So the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. Made his first, this now from 42 yards out. And his kick is indeed good. And that will stretch the lead up to 13. So they settle for just the three there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the fourth.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. But three does give them some breathing room and lets them build up a little cushion.
Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This fielded at the two. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Bengal offense now gets set to head back out onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
First and 10 for Dalton. To the left side here for Eifert. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Give him 17 and a Cincinnati first down. On first and 10, here's Andy Dalton. Underneath here to Hill. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. It's a Bengal first down, a pickup of 11. First down now, but that clock rolling. Dalton, first and 10, shedding through the defense. Looking left sideline, incomplete.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
On second down now, Hill. And he's going to get this inside the 30. He'll get 14 on that one. Good for a Bengal first down. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Now Dalton with a first and 10. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. But not the position they want to be in. Still a very, very small chance here, but they almost need a miracle.
Agreed. That means they've got to get it to the sidelines, get out of bounds, and preserve clock.
Another look for Dalton on second and 10. Green's got it over the middle. And he's brought down. The connection since 2011. Dalton to Green for a Bengal first down. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Dalton. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
You know, every time we talk with people about the most important quality for a quarterback to have in the NFL, what do they usually cite?
Arm strength.
Yeah, that's really way down on the list. Accuracy is one of the bigger ones, maybe the foremost one. That's what he needed on that play.
Now whistles and a flag, and I believe a Bengal got going a little early there.
Foster, offense.
That's going to set him back 5 yards. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. Another chance for Dalton. He's going to let it fly. And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
And there's going to be a stoppage here. The booth wants to take another look at this potential touchdown. Here's Bullock now for the extra point. And the lead will shrink to 6. So that drive in total, 8 plays. And it ends with a Bengals score. So with an even 30 seconds to go, everything will come down to this onside kick. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. Fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them. And now the Bengals are going to call another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. Down to a knee here as the Texans look to let the clock roll. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. The Texans on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This is going to be 3rd and 13. Down to a knee here as the Texans look to let the clock roll. Here's Shane Lechler now. He's been terrific so far. Well, I know at points in this one you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard. You're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball parks, right? Seeing the 14-11 game, that sort of deal. That's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. From Cincinnati, good night, everyone.